Good morning class. So yesterday I have told about the refractive index and I have told that it is the ratio. So refractive index is the ratio of velocity of light into media. It means refractive index, suppose we have two medium, let this is medium 1 and this is medium 2, and in medium 1 the velocity of light is v1 and in medium 2 velocity of light is v2. So refractive index of medium 2 with respect to 1 is, I have told that for the medium we want to calculate the refractive index, its velocity should be in denominator. So this is, we want to calculate the refractive index of medium 2, so its velocity is v2, it should be in denominator, and the other medium is in numerator. Okay, now if we want to calculate the refractive index of medium 1 with respect to 2, simple. The velocity of this medium 1 we have to put in denominator and other medium in numerator. So we have these two formula in terms of velocity, clear? Or in terms of angle, so if this is the case, this is angle of incidence, this is I, and this is angle of refraction R, this is medium 2, this is medium 1. So N21 is equals to sine I by sine R, and N12 will be its opposite, sine R by sine I. How can we write this? Because I have derived the formula N21 is equals to 1 upon N12. Okay, so using these formula we will do some numericals. Now suppose we have a question that the velocity of light in air is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and the velocity of light in glass is 2.14 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So we have to calculate the refractive index of glass with respect to air and refractive index of air with respect to glass. So first write down what is given. Velocity of light is equals to 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and velocity of glass, velocity in glass is equals to 2.14 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So first we have to calculate the refractive index of glass with respect to air. It should be, I have told that if we want to calculate the refractive index of glass, so its velocity should be in denominator, so this should be vg, velocity of glass, and in numerator va. This will be, va is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second divided by 2.14 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. So in 10 to the power 8 cut, so this is 3 by 2.14 is equals to, this is equals to 1.4. So the refractive index of glass with respect to air is 1.4, means it is greater than 1. If refractive index is greater than 1, then the medium is denser. Okay, means larger the value of refractive index, denser will be the medium. And as we can see from here, the velocity is 2.14, which is less than this, so this is rarer, this medium is rarer and this medium is denser. Okay, now next question is, there are four media, okay, having refractive index 1.76, 1.4, 2.6 and 2.0. So question is, in which medium the velocity of light is minimum and in which medium it is maximum? So we know that velocity of light will be maximum in which medium? Which is rarer, and velocity of light will be minimum which is denser. So now we have to check which medium is rarer and which medium is denser. I have told the more the value of refractive index, denser will be the medium. Less the value of refractive index, rarer will be the medium. So more the value of refractive index, denser will be the medium, and less the value of refractive index, rarer will be the medium. Means we have to find out which medium is denser. So from these value we know that 2.6 is maximum, so 2.6 is denser. Means in this medium velocity of light will be minimum. Clear? And the lowest value is 1.4. So in 1.4 it is rarer. So in this medium velocity of light will be maximum. Clear? So this is how we do the question. So next question is, light is going from air to different media making the angle of refraction 30 degree, 40 degree, 25 degree and 70 degree for the same angle of incidence. So which medium has the higher refractive index? So we have to apply the Snell's law. So see how we do this question solution. So we have different media, means this is medium A, this is medium B, this is medium C, this is medium D. So let this is medium A, this is medium B, this is medium C, and this is medium D. Okay. So first medium is air, because light is going from air. This is also air, this is also air, and this is also air. But this is medium A. This is medium A, this is medium B, this is medium C, this is medium D. So for the same angle of incidence, suppose angle of incidence is angle I. Here also angle I. Here also I. Angle I. And here also angle I. So all these angles are same, but the angle of refraction is different. So for medium 1, this is 30 degree, this is 30, this is 40, this is 25, and this is 70. Okay, so we have different angle. This is 30 degree, this is 40 degree, this is 25 degree, this is 70 degree. Okay. So apply the Snell's law. We know that the refractive index of medium A with respect to air will be sine I by sine 30. Okay. So here refractive index of B with respect to air is equals to sine I by sine 40. Similarly, refractive index of C with respect to air is equals to sine I by sine 25 degree, and refractive index of D will be sine I by sine 70 degree. Now we can see that the refractive index of any medium, suppose any medium X, is inversely proportional to its angle of refraction. sine r. Okay, so more the value of this angle, more the value of sine r. So more the value of r, more will be the value of sine r. Clear? And hence less will be the value of refractive index. Clear? Because it is directly inversely proportional to sine r. So more the value of sine r, less will be the refractive index. So we know that we have to just find which angle is maximum. So we know that sine 70 degrees maximum. So sine 70 will be larger than all of these angles. Okay, so we know that sine 70 will be greater than all these three angles. So refractive index of medium D will be lower because it is inversely proportional. So maximum the value of this, minimum will be this. Okay, so we know that ND will be lower, and if the refractive index is lower, so maximum velocity will be in this medium. Maximum velocity will be in this medium. Clear? So what have we done? We know that the refractive index of any medium is inversely proportional to the angle of refraction. Means more the angle of refraction, more will be the value of sine r, and less will be the refractive index. And less will be the refractive index means more will be the velocity of light, because it will be the rarer medium. Okay. Now let us talk about the absolute refractive index. Absolute refractive index. What is absolute refractive index? So refractive index of any medium with respect to air or vacuum is called absolute refractive index. Okay, so what is absolute refractive index? Refractive index of any medium with respect to air or vacuum is called absolute refractive index. Means if I'm saying the refractive index of glass with respect to air, it is just absolute refractive index of glass. This is absolute refractive index of glass. Okay, if I'm saying the refractive index of water with respect to air, it is also absolute refractive index. Okay, so refractive index of any medium with respect to air or vacuum will be the absolute refractive index, and it is denoted by n of refractive index of any medium. Let ng means absolute refractive index of glass, na absolute refractive index of air, n water absolute refractive index of water. So means it is self understood that these are given with respect to air and vacuum, so we need not to mention the air or vacuum. Okay, so suppose refractive index of glass with respect to water is given, suppose. Okay, so this is refractive index of glass with respect to water. So it is also equals to the absolute refractive index of glass divided by the absolute refractive index of water. This is the formula. Okay, so what is NGW? The refractive index of glass with respect to water, which is equals to the refractive index of glass divided by refractive index of water. We can prove it. It is very simple. We know that prove. So we know that ng is the refractive index of glass with respect to water. So the velocity of glass will be in denominator, so vg. Okay, and the refractive index with respect to air, the speed of air is c, the speed of light in air is c, where nw is equals to vw upon c. So this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Now we want to calculate the refractive index, suppose divide these two. Ng divided by Nw will be equals to Vw by Vg. And this is the refractive index of glass with respect to water. Recall the formula of velocity, relation between velocity and refractive index. So if we want to calculate the refractive index of glass, its velocity will be denominator, and with respect to water it will be in numerator. So this we can write this. So from here ngw can be written as ng divided by nw, means absolute refractive index of glass divided by absolute refractive index of water. This is how we calculate the refractive index of any medium with respect to the other medium. Okay, so now suppose we have a question which is the absolute refractive index of diamond is 2.4, glass is 1.4 and alcohol is 1.6. And what is the refractive index of the following? First, refractive index of glass with respect to diamond, refractive index of glass with respect to alcohol, and refractive index of alcohol with respect to diamond. So this is refractive index of glass with respect to diamond, this is refractive index of glass with respect to alcohol, and this is refractive index of alcohol with respect to diamond. So these three quantity we have to calculate. Okay, so remember one thing, if it is not given that absolute refractive index and simply it is written that the refractive index of diamond is 2.4. Okay, so if it is given the refractive index of diamond is 2.4 and it is not given with respect to which medium, so we will always taken as the refractive index of diamond with respect to air. Okay, means if it is simply given the refractive index of diamond is 2.4, means it is the absolute refractive index of diamond. Okay, so first write down what is given. What is given? The refractive index of diamond, the refractive index of diamond is 2.4, means the refractive index of diamond is equals to 2.4. The refractive index of glass is 1.4. And the refractive index of alcohol is 1.6. Refractive index of alcohol is equals to 1.6. Okay, so first we have to calculate the refractive index of glass with respect to diamond. We know that from formula this should be the absolute refractive index of glass divided by absolute refractive index of diamond. So the absolute refractive index of glass is 1.4 divided by absolute refractive index of diamond, this is 2.4. okay, so its value is 0.58. so the refractive index of glass with respect to diamond is 0.58. second, the refractive index of glass with respect to air is refractive index of glass divided by refractive index of air. Okay, so what is the refractive index of glass? 1.4 divided by, what is the refractive index of alcohol, 1.6. so this is equals to 0.875. okay, third is the refractive index of alcohol with respect to diamond. So this will be the refractive index of alcohol, means the absolute refractive index of alcohol divided by the absolute refractive index of diamond. So this will be, what is the absolute refractive index of alcohol? This is 1.6 divided by the refractive index of diamond, which is 2.4. so this is equals to 0.66 bar. okay, so this is how we calculate the refractive index of any medium with respect to the other medium if the absolute refractive index of any medium is given. Okay, so this is all for today. So tomorrow we will do the more numericals and we will study about the spherical lenses. Okay, so thank you.